We are Violent Femmes, and you're watching
Speaker TV.
Been together for 33 years. Probably the main incentive to have such longevity in a band as what we have with 33 years of Violent Femmes would be the regeneration of the audience that we've been able to experience. Because, for example, last night we played for many thousands of people, and yet almost all of them were, less than 33 years old. So it's gratifying to see that new people are always getting into it. And that's a reason to keep going around.
Love playing with other musicians, and particularly with improvisation. And so we've had lots and lots of people over the years that will sometimes join up with on a tour. Sometimes with certain people we've played with a lot over the years, and other people it might just be one time, one place that somebody's there and we're able to invite them to join us. And the core or the concept of that as a group, which is what we call Horns of Dilemma. And one of the concepts, at least how I understand it, is that not just the usual of having one person take a solo, but often total group improvisation, or in a sense of everybody thinking that it's their solo, which isn't really accurate to say that. Hopefully that's not really the case, although that's better than everybody just waiting for somebody else to do something. We have a concept of improvising as an entire group in certain sections of certain songs, or sometimes it might happen by surprise at some point.
We'll have friends drop in. Like tonight, we'll have Spencer P. Jones from The Beast of Bourbon and Jack Howard from Hunters and Collectors. But it could be anybody. You know, in different cities, it's different people.
That was actually my first introduction to playing with you guys in San Jose.
Oh.
When Dresden
Dolls
played.
So you graduated from the Horns of Dilemma to the
guest groveling opening band to official member. Ta-da.
Recorded the album, the first Violent Femmes album, we decided that we would try to avoid anything that might date the recording. So if you listen to it now, it actually could be recorded right now. There's not any kind of technology being used that particularly says it's from the early 80s. And then, of course, the other thing that's eternal about it is the sentiments that are being expressed in the songs, which very clearly articulate a lot of the way a lot of people feel, mainly adolescents, I suppose, but anybody can relate to it because they've all had these kinds of emotions that are expressed in a lot of the songs. So at least they seem to relate to it.
It's gone, daddy, gone.
Robin, we played a New Year's Eve in Chicago as his band. Although, at least for me, that was kind of an evolving discovery in the moment that we were really
part of the evolution was when Dennis dumped a beer on Gordon's head. That was
I don't remember that, but anyway.
I can see by the way that you baby talk. I can know by the way that you treat your man. I can love you, babe, it's a crime. Cause it's gone, daddy, gone. Love is gone, yes, it's gone, daddy, gone. Love is gone, gone, daddy, gone. Love is gone, daddy, gone. Beautiful girl, love is dressed.